If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that Dalle3 is now embedded into ChatGPT. I've been testing Dalle3 since then, creating imagery and even materials. In this video, I'm going to show you how it can be used and you can see what it can and can't do. Unless you are anti-tech, you'll probably be using ChatGPT in some way in your interior design workflow. I've been doing a deep dive into AI and how it can be used in my interior design. If you haven't already, check out my videos on Midjourney and Dalle 3. I'm talking to you in October 2023. Last week, I showed you how you could sneakily use Dalle within Bing, and it is testament to how fast this AI world works that this week it is already embedded into ChatGPT, and that is if you have a Plus account. If you do have a Pro account, head over to ChatGPT and choose the option Dalle 3 from the drop-down list. You'll be able to write prompts in your natural language to then generate images. Let's challenge ChatGPT to see if it can help us design a room. I have an example project where I asked ChatGPT to help me create a high-end bedroom. I described the materials and what I wanted the room to contain. So let's head over to ChatGPT and take a look. So first of all, I asked Dalle to help me design a room, and Dalle suggested that they could help me in six ways. First being inspiration ideas, so suggestions based on design trends, historical styles, or specific themes. So one of the tricks to using Dalle 3 and ChatGPT is making sure that you're following these prompt recommendations. Then they can help me suggest layouts so we can describe the room's dimensions and the purpose of the room. And then ChatGPT can propose potential layout. And then they'll illustrate those layouts for better visual understanding. The third way is to recommend color palettes. GPT can suggest color combinations based on desired moods or trending colors. And they can create visual swatches with the colors, and then they propose furniture and decor ideas. We can share our style preferences, and ChatGPT can recommend furniture and decor pieces. Dalle can produce images of those furniture pieces or how they might look in a room setting. Feedback on existing designs is also offered, so you can describe an existing concept. It won't allow you to upload images. So this is to do with privacy concerns, according to ChatGPT. But Dalle can offer visual modifications. If you describe it in words, it can offer modifications that you can incorporate into your design. You can actually set your prompt and tell them a little bit about you so they can tailor the content to you. So they know I'm an interior design coach, and so they suggest that ChatGPT can help provide insights and so on. You can judge for yourself with the results that we generate whether this indeed is true. Then I am going to use a description to generate some images. Now that I have determined that Dalle and ChatGPT can help me out with this, I have now created this prompt. My prompt is, I want to design a bedroom in a classic contemporary style. Materials I will use in this room include high-end finishes like grey oak, mohair velvet, and oil-rubbed bronze. These are not like common sort of IKEA type suggestions. I was hoping to get something that was a little bit more elevated than IKEA, which is what I've seemed to be getting when I am putting in prompts. I also suggested the room will be natural tone with accents of steel blue. I chose steel blue because the color is, slightly off the wall. It's not just blue, but more specific. And what I'm trying to test is how easily does ChatGPT interpret this brief. Okay, so let's see what it does. Now, before we move on to the images that Dalle suggested, if you want to learn more about how to use prompts to generate images, then make sure you check the link in my description box and the comment section below, because I have a free Notion template that will dive deeper on how to write the best prompts for AI engines like Midjourney and Dall-E. This guide will walk you through how to create prompts as well as help you save the images that you generate. Again, make sure you click the link in my description. Now, with that out of the way, let's move on to the next part of my ChatGPT challenge on how Dall-E can help you create a room design. So Dall-E then came up with a little bit of a concept. They suggested layout, where the bed placement will be, the seating area and storage. And they suggested a seating area with mohair velvet chairs. So you can see that they are actually suggesting materials to be used for specific pieces of furniture. And they said opt for built-in wardrobes in gray oak finish. So that is definitely a design choice. They said include a dresser or a chest of drawers. Very practical advice. The color palette. So you've got your walls, which they suggested should be a soft neutral tone, and one accent wall in steel blue. So again, you could test that. I'm not a huge fan of accent walls, but it's a good suggestion for some design variation. And then they suggested that the ceilings are kept light, perhaps an op white to make sure that the room feels spacious. And then with the textiles, you could use mohair velvet cushions or throw pillows, and neutral toned bed linens and drapes will blend seamlessly. They've talked about materials and finishes. So gray oak for furniture pieces, including the bed frame, side tables, storage units, oil rub bronze handles for wardrobe, dresser and side tables, and then light fixtures in the oil rub bronze. So again, the textiles, the upholstery mohair velvet provides a touch of softness and luxury, then suggests decor and accessories, artwork, lighting, rug, and all of these suggestions are pretty good and very similar to actually what I would suggest, I'm afraid to say. And then finally, it asks whether they can create some visual representations to give me a better picture and would I like to see them. And of course, I'd like to see them. So that is the design concept. Before we go on, if you like this content, please do me a favor and subscribe. It really helps to notify the algorithm that this content is useful and will suggest my channel to other designers. Most of my viewers are not subscribers, so I hope you're not one of them. Thank you for giving me a hand. So let's head back. You can see here, this is what Dall-E came up with, and actually they're pretty good. I particularly like this one. As I said, I'm not a huge fan of the old wall, but I do like the paneling and the joinery. There's a few kind of weird things going on. I'm not sure what happened to a bedhead here, and it's against a window, so I like the joinery. I also like this layout. I like that bedhead. That's pretty luxurious. So I think in terms of the steel blue, the concept is really nice. I like these fittings. I'd probably go with something a little bit more simple for this room. I like the images that they generated, and I think the concept's actually really nice, and it has interpreted the brief really well. So you can see here, they give you a little bit of an explanation and they say why they've actually chosen. So I guess you could develop, you could choose this image and say, give me five variations on this. So it's really quite quick for image representation and generation. Now, I want to ask ChatGPT to help me with actually putting together this design in real life. So I asked it to create a list of things that I would need to source. Let's head over to take a look. So here we are back in ChatGPT, and I asked them to create me a list of items I would have to source for a room like this. Here's a nice list of items, and I have to say it's pretty good. You can see that there's a detailed list, and it's got the bed, size tables, dressers, chest of drawers, seating area, built-in wardrobes. Then it's looked at the textiles, the lighting that you would need, artwork, decorative items, cushions, handles, light fixtures and so on, paint and finishing, walls and ceiling, and miscellaneous. Now I asked it to help me with some details. I asked it to suggest some paint colors from two suppliers, Farrow & Ball and Benjamin Moore. Again, I thought it did a pretty good job. You would have to note that these are not probably the best colors, but they certainly give me a starting point to look. they've suggested these colors, neutral tones, elephant's breath, skimming stone, cornforth white, all actually really good choices, and the steel blue accents, the stiff key blue, Dick's blue. So I guess these wouldn't be the latest colors because ChatGPT is not incredibly up to date, but it would be fairly recent. So they've also suggested Benjamin Moore. You could try with other smaller paint designers and paint color examples. So I also tried to look at whether they could send me some ideas of suppliers and manufacturers of mohair velvet. I actually considered this a bit niche, but if you look at the results, they are all incredibly realistic. I actually really liked the last one, Rubelli. This is my favorite supplier of mohair velvet. And I thought as the list was being generated that they missed that one, but then it popped up at the last one. So I was very pleasantly surprised. I'm happy to say that Rubelli made the list, and actually this is a very good list for any designer to start checking out options. Now, as you recall, ChatGPT said it could generate a layout. Let's put that to the test. I asked it to use image 2 as a guide for the floor plan. And as you can see, the result was not that good. If you look at the measurements here, they're not particularly accurate representations of what actually I asked it to do. I'm not sure if this should be the 5 and this should be the 4. And you can see here, this is wrong. I'm not quite sure what's happening with these details here. It looks like the doors are sideways. So you can see this floor plan is a little bit inaccurate. I don't mind the layout. I guess this is just meant to represent paneling. There is this round tufted ottoman, and you can see here the detail here. It's like a side view of what this is, and I'm not exactly sure what this is going to be. Although the concept of a little kind of bedroom seating area is cute, but obviously this is way too narrow. But it did explain what it meant, and I wasn't quite sure about it. So I said, could you regenerate? Could you take these two chairs, put them closer together, and also draw me the plan in a more minimal architectural style? So they did it. This looks slightly better, but you've got these kind of doors here. You've lost a little bit of the detail. Not sure what that is there. Not sure what this is here, why you'd have plants on top of, I think it's meant to be a cupboard, so on. You can see the limitations, but they have, if you actually read what they have suggested, it's not too bad. I actually then said, oh, it's very different to the first plan. Could you regenerate that plan using these instructions? So we've got these other materials that nothing to do with the first image that we generated. If you have a look here, what I actually asked them to do was generate a floor plan based on this view, and it certainly did not do that. So as you can see, this demonstration shows the limitations of using Dalle-E for being a floor plan generator. As you've probably guessed, AI can comfortably provide definitions, can generate lists and imagery that are aligned with the prompts. However, it can't put the design together, let alone make it a reality by sourcing materials, fixtures, and fittings, putting the whole design into a physical space. For the moment, I think our jobs are safe. I hope you enjoyed this video and that you can now confidently incorporate ChatGPT and Dalle into your interior design workflow to save you a little bit of work. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in my next one.